Hello everyone, in this video we have one quadrilateral. Its length is given 5, here is given 3, and this side is given 6. Angle ADC is given 90 degrees. Base angles are given as equal. The question is, what is the length of the axis? Okay. First step. If we extend corner D and corner A like this, let's call here point K. And if you focus on the biggest triangle, the biggest triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? So triangle BKC is an isosceles triangle. Then let's call here A. That means this length must be equal A plus 1, right? So for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of A, right? Therefore, A squared plus 3 squared equal A plus 1 whole squared. A squared plus 9 equal A squared plus 2A plus 1. These are again 2A equal 8. That means A is going to be 4 units. Okay. If you pay attention, actually this equation belongs to the 3, 4, 5 spatial right triangle. That's right here. A equal 4. So here must be equal 5. And let's call here theta. If you focus on the biggest triangle, for biggest triangle, if you apply cosine rule, we get to the value of x, right? Therefore, x squared equal 10 squared plus 10 squared minus 2 times 10 times 10 times cosine theta. So if you focus on triangle KAD, for this triangle, cosine theta equal 4 over 5, right? Therefore, if we substitute this value into the equation, let's write here 4 over 5. And if you simplify, so we get x squared equal 100 plus 100 minus 160. That means x squared equal 40. So x is going to be 2 root 10. Okay. So as the first method, now we will calculate value of x using second method. Okay. First step, if we draw a parallel line to line BC like this, let's call here point T, and if you notice that, we get an isosceles trapezoid, right? So BCTA is an isosceles trapezoid. Therefore, if it is 5, that means this length is also 5 units, so 1 unit left here. This time, let's draw a parallel line to line AB like this. Let's call here point S. So if you notice that, we get a parallelogram, right? So BCTA is a parallelogram. Therefore, if it is 5 units, this length is also 5, right? And if it is alpha, here is also alpha, and these angles should be equal, right? Because of corresponding angles. If you focus on triangle STC, this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? Therefore, if we draw a perpendicular line onto the base, like this, the base will be divided into two equal parts, right? So I want to represent this two equal length as M unit, and let's call here angle theta. Here must be equal angle theta, right? Then if you focus on triangle ADT, this triangle and this triangle have same angles. That means these two triangles are similar. So triangle ADT and triangle, let's call here P, TPC are similar, right? After that, let's call here Y. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get to the value of Y, right? So 1 squared plus 3 squared equal Y squared. That means y is going to be root 10. That's right here, root 10. So here is also root 10, right? Now, if you start applying the similarity theorem to this triangle, 1, which is opposite of the theta, over m, which is opposite of the theta, equal root 10, which is opposite of 90 degrees, over 5, which is opposite of 90 degrees. Therefore, M is going to be 5 over root 10. Right? So, notice that 2M equal 10 over root 10. So 2m equal root 10, right? That means x equal root 10 plus root 10. So x is going to be 2 root 10. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.